A vast ocean of drifting sands and scorched, sun-baked rocks. Beneath these endless dunes, oil, the lifeblood of our new mechanical century. For more than 400 years, the Ottoman Empire has ruled these lands, controlling all that's to be found here. But the Ottomans do not rule unopposed. Small bands of Bedouin rebels have united to overthrow the empire. They strike without warning and then vanish into the desert. Fighting alongside them is a lone British officer whose exploits have earned him wide renown. The world has taken to calling this man Lawrence of Arabia. In the desert, you rely on good planning, but you also hope for a dash of luck. And luck was with us when we learned of a recently derailed Ottoman train carrying a most interesting piece of cargo. A small patrol had joined the Ottomans who survived the crash. Together, they guarded the wreckage and waited for reinforcements. A lone fighter has just one advantage over a large enemy force. A lone fighter can move unseen. Cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war.
Yeti geldi! Ya teslim ol ya da gebert!
Thank you.
there's a world of difference between seeing something and having it in your own two hands.
You did not think we would be fast enough to catch you here, did you?
Lawrence of Arabia.
Actually, I was rather depending on it. Eh, Lawrence? Well, this is very clever. Now the hunter becomes the hunted. So who might you be? How enchanting you are, my dear.
Ahmed.
I'll show you enchanting. If it weren't for you, I'd be free.
Free, is it? You'll be free when you're dead. And I'm happy to tell you, the Empire intends to grant you all this freedom very soon. Even now, an engine of destruction scours this desert, obliterating your allies. Your families, your homes. Soon there will be nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide. Soon all that you know, and all that you love, will be ashes. You will all be free. To die. Oh. Ah, you animal!
Zara!
I understand that you would like nothing more than to strip the flesh from that man's feet and send him off into the desert naked to die. But think about it.
You're right.
I'm sorry. My friend here, she can be a little brusque.
You're going to tell me how to lie to your train so we can lure it into a trap and destroy it.
Impossible. To even begin to talk to that train, you would need an entire book of communication codes.
Oh, like this one, you mean?
You can never stop the progress of machines! One day, the whole world will take your lands and the precious black gold beneath its sands!
We shall see, my friend. Of course, obtaining the codebook was not enough. To destroy this iron dragon, this Canavar, as the Ottomans had named it, we had to send it three encrypted messages telling it to stand down. There were Ottoman outposts scattered along the railroad tracks. The commanders there carried high-priority message capsules. We had to use those to send our orders. Infiltrating the village wouldn't be easy. A full detachment of Ottoman soldiers had occupied it. The Ottomans had chosen an isolated location for their desert outpost. It seemed lightly defended. It was also well stocked with arms and equipment. The ancient ruins were all that remained of a civilization now lost to time. The Ottoman Empire brought in the modern world with a host of armored vehicles and field guns. Three commanders to eliminate, three personal message capsules to be stolen, and then sent with our false orders. How Zara tackled this dangerous and audacious mission was up to her. The Bedouin treasured their horses, and in return, those animals granted their riders unparalleled speed and mobility. A single order wouldn't be enough. Ottoman protocol required the message to be received in triplicate before the train would acknowledge it as genuine.
Yeah.